Hello, Kent Weakley here, and I'm excited to share with you my brand new historic Lightroom presets. Yeah, you heard me right. New historic presets. They're brand new, but they have a historic flair. Let me explain. See, I love history, and I love images from different time periods. Occasionally, there are particular images that I create for my own use and for clients that I need to make them look as if they have a particular historic appearance to them. I've done a variety here and there, but I started thinking, why not make a complete collection? If you would like to follow along, make sure you have the KW historic presets loaded, and you're going to see a folder that looks like this. Just go ahead and open it up, and you're going to see all the historic presets here. The very first image that was ever recorded and archived, which is credited for being the very first photo, was made by a Frenchman named Joseph Niepce. And he basically created what was a photo-engraved printing plate. I started looking at that image and started thinking, wait, can I recreate the look of that image with Lightroom settings? And here's what I've come up with. So we're going to take this image, and what you're seeing on the screen right now is straight out of the camera, and we're going to go back in time to 1826. And this is how that image may have appeared in 1826. Let's fast forward 23 years to the 1849 California Gold Rush. The quality is getting dramatically better compared to the first recorded image. How about another 40-some years and we'll go to the 1893 World's Fair in Chicago. Now what I did is I took images from those time periods and mimicked them with Lightroom settings. And now you can quickly take your images and jettison them back in time to a particular time period that you're looking for. How about 1903, when the Wright brothers are flying in Kitty Hawk? Remember the images of them in the sand dunes off the coast of North Carolina? Well, this is replicating that look. Let's take a look at a different image. This is an image of a woman in Peru. And this again is straight out of the camera. Let's see what she might look like in 1936 during the Dust Bowl. Think of the journalistic images going around at the time in 1936 when the Dust Bowl is occurring. Think of the historic images. Let's fast forward a little bit more. It's the end of World War II and we're at Times Square now. Of course, this is the Golden Gate Bridge in Baker Beach in California, but think of the crisp, sharp, black and white image of the sailor and the nurse that was captured by Alfred Eisenstead in Times Square. And let's transport this image to that. There we are. We've jumped back in time 70-some years. All right, and now this one's really cool. I like going through the progression here. I'm going to go through the entire progression with this image for you. Okay, so here's a straight out of camera image. And we're going to go back to 1826, Joseph Niepce. 1894, Gold Rush. 1893, World's Fair. 1903, Wright Flyer. 1929, Roaring Twenties. 1936, Dust Bowl. 1945, Times Square. How about the birth of rock and roll in the 1950s? The hippie movement in the 1960s. Apollo 11's launch in 1969. Flower power from the 70s. The first space shuttle launch, 1981. Tearing down of the Berlin Wall of 1989. I'm only 100 years off there. How about the 1990s, film to digital, starting to make that transition. Y2K. And the 20-teens, HDR. pretty cool. I'm really excited about this set because there's so much that you can do with it. And of course, all of these presets are starting points. You can work with the different development tools once you've applied one of these and make additional adjustments if you choose, or you can use them just like they are. This little guy, this little girl from is also from Peru. I like looking at this and imagining it in the mid-1800s, or again, there's that Dust Bowl look. It's really crisp and clean. It's just a slight tint. And then all the way up through HDR. It's amazing, all of the different settings here. You know, take a look at the Brooklyn Bridge. Going through the same setups. And what happens is there's different film and capturing. It wasn't always film, obviously. There were glass plates, there was etchings initially. There were a variety of different ways of capturing that, plus the different camera technology combined to make different looks. And different eras throughout history had different looks of photography. What we're looking at here are 16 presets that recreate a time span of almost 200 years of the history of photography. It'd be great to see some of the images that you create using these presets. Feel free to email those directly to me. And you can also post them up at the P52 post every Tuesday on my blog. So I hope you enjoy that. Check out my plugins on my site. You can download those there. And have some fun with it. Thanks for checking us out. If you haven't already, please subscribe to my channel.